Listen, am I the only person who's grown more tolerant and accepting of excessively long movies in the lockdown? I watched two in the last 2 days and dono mein maze aaye. Today we're talking about the new Amazon Prime Video release, Malik. Fahad Fazil teams up with director Mahesh Narayanan again after their computer screen genre film See You Soon, which I wasn't a very big fan of, frankly. Here we meet an old aging gangster with a heart of gold. Suleiman is leaving his heavily crowded home to head for Hajj. Heavily crowded because he's like a local outlaw godfather of the masses, and there's a feast as he departs for the holy pilgrimage. Lekin, before he could even board the plane out of India, he's apprehended and taken into custody. Then the film shows you via three different flashbacks what has led to this point. Because Fahad Fazil's character, Ahmad Ali Suleiman, goes from 6 years old to what seems like early 50s, the movie is very long, nearly 3 hours. So be patient with it. And if you do take my word generally, here I would like to assure you that once you find your footing through Malik, about 20 to 30 minutes into the film, or up to the point the first flashback actually begins, there is a ton to cherish. The storytelling only gets better and better from that point on. Suleiman is from a Muslim community so impoverished they don't have pakka homes to live in. Their huts are in the middle of a literal garbage dump. The smell doesn't even bother them because that's all they know. The coast they live on, the sea, is their livelihood. That's where the fish, which they sell to the locals, and the smuggled goods come in. The only way for the residents of this village to earn money and grow within one generation, unfortunately, is a life of crime. Suleiman's ambitions are bigger than most, hence his rises too. From a small-time smuggled goods supplier to seller to store and godown owner and subsequent don type, his rise is fast and hence enemies are many. Because director Mahesh Narayanan has also written and edited the film, his control over it is absolute and evident. He doesn't shy away from exploration. There is the coming of age slash maturation plot because you see the character's journey. Then there's also commentary on systemic poverty and system-wide corruption, how easy it is to sow communal discord and how rapidly it can get out of hand, interfaith love and what that really means in the real world, male friendships, climate change, India's technical evolution, and above all, the conflict that lies at the heart of all gangster stories: the family you're born into versus the family you choose for yourself. Mahesh Narayanan's script and screenplay are extraordinarily clear and focused. A 17-year-old has been sent to a prison where Suleiman is also lodged, and this kid now has 14 days where the police has conspired with local neta types to get the 17-year-old to kill Suleiman. Yani, script mein inbuilt reverse timer hai. Isse hota ye hai ki narrative aapka band jata hai kyunki itni badi story mein phailne ki gunjayish zyada hai. Within these 14 days, the boy has to decide what he's going to do, how he will do it, and whether he should do it at all. Various people come to the prison and then narrate stories to this boy, which become the flashbacks, jahan you will find yourself settling in and watching. And you know, it's not Rashomon. The stories are all about Suleiman, who's also called Ali Ikka, but they aren't about the same incident told from different perspectives. Instead, these stories very cleverly cover three different parts of his life. The estranged mother talks of his childhood and early youth, estranged best friend slash partner in literal crime talks of their heyday, and then finally Suleiman himself goes back in time to fill in the gaps left empty by the previous two narrators. Good gangster movies, spanning from origin story to eventual fate, are almost always long. The Irishman, most recently, Gangs of Wasseypur is in two parts. Goodfellas was 2.5 hours. The Godfather movies, Gangs of New York. And yet, we don't complain about the length of these films where we watch them over and over again. Because perhaps a long runtime is something the genre demands. For these movies to work as stories beyond the technical achievements of, you know, aging or de-aging, old-timey production design, etc., they must also capture the essence of the time period, the politics of the time, the economic status of the various classes, and how all of that affects personal relationships and drove the protagonist to stumble from one situation into another until they reach a position of power, they can take their own decisions, they look back on what brought them there, and there's almost always certainly a sense of regret or search for redemption, repentance. So on these metrics, Malik is formulaic. It follows all the tropes. And yet, it's not unoriginal. The stories in this film are very real, very Indian. The acting performances from Fahad Fazil, Nimisha Sajayan, they're just about as extraordinary as you would expect them to be. In fact, the star cast is massive, as you will see, each and everyone just as good as the other. Vinay Fort, Juju George, Sanal Aman. And yes, it is a majority male cast, kyunki gangster paradise mein toh aadmi aadmi milenge. Lekin the film never gets too testosterone-y to handle. Only one bad guy makes it about his ego, the rest of it remains steadfastly about circumstances and forced hands which propel the story forward, as opposed to badla and dushman and main tujhe dikhata hu who is the boss. Jag mein thandram. Anywho, the film is streaming on Amazon Prime Video. If you have a subscription, dekhna. Ye zara itminan wali Sunday ki film hai, lunch time aaram se. Now for relation mein recommendation. If you like Fahad Fazil in Malik and you'd like to see a display of acting range, check out Madhusen Narayanan's Kumbhalangi Nights if you haven't watched it already. It's a very popular film. Fahad Fazil's is probably the shortest part in the film, but one with max recall. Kumbhalangi Nights is also streaming on Amazon Prime Video. Bonus! Relation mein recommendation. Another Malayalam language movie starring Nimisha Sajayan, just being her talented self, is The Great Indian Kitchen. Originally, it was streaming on NeeStream. Now, it is also on Amazon Prime. You'll find my review of the film here. Subscribe kar le mere channel ko, bas badle mein, that's all I need. Like, that's literally all I'm asking for. Oh, also, if you like my merch, there is the merch shelf right under this video. Go click and buy my t-shirts. Don't be a chumo.